Welcome back to The Perspective. Still with us is spokesperson for Java Mountain Coffee, Ms. Nadine Alexandra. So Ms. Nadine, we established earlier that the two cooperatives from Java Mountain Coffee are the first all-women farmers cooperative. What kind of public reception has these cooperatives got?
So I touched upon this a bit earlier, how there's been, you know, at times a mixed bag of responses, and there have been some people who don't have the same shared values that we do about gender equality,
right,
about combating the realities of climate change. But, you know, we're not really here to ponder on those, you know, few negative experiences.
Because you've gotten great reception, you've gotten great support from the government.
Yes, exactly. And, you know, we have actually met people in important decision-making positions in the government who are fully supportive, and that's really, really encouraging. And then on the other hand, we've also had, you know, overwhelming support from, you know, corporates, hotels, restaurants, and cafes, because there seems to be a trend, and, you know, I don't really like saying trend because it alludes to something that's
just temporary.
Exactly, and just, you know, fashionable for that moment. But there seems to be a growing awareness towards people caring more about the environment and about social justices and gender equality.
Right.
And, you know, seeing that, you know, trend, it's extremely encouraging, and you know, we're very grateful to have encountered the people that we have who show their 100% full support for Java Mountain Coffee.
As I understand, you've actually just recently had a new a partnership with the Conrad Bali?
Yes, so that was, I think, about 2 months ago. And like I said, you know, from corporates and hotels, there's an overwhelmingly good reception.
Right.
Yeah.
And they will be providing these coffees in their hotels and their restaurants and whatnot.
Exactly. And actually, one of the other things that we've done with the Conrad Bali is that we've come up with these new biodegradable Nespresso machine compatible coffee capsules.
Okay.
And so the problem in the past has been, you know,
it's one of those little capsules that you put in like a Keurig machine.
Exactly.
Right.
But they're usually non-biodegradable.
Okay. They're usually plastic.
Exactly.
And aluminum.
Exactly.
Okay.
So these ones are made from corn waste, and they've been certified by an independent Belgian laboratory. That have stated that within 90 days in commercial compost, they will degrade. They will.
They will be able to. They won't be adding into the number of garbage that we throw out. It's not going to be toxic to the air, to the environment.
Exactly.
It's actually going to be helping the environment.
Yes, exactly.
So that's one of the innovations that Java Mountain Coffee has brought up. Is there any other innovations that the social enterprise has been looking at?
I think we've actually covered
most
of everything that Java Mountain Coffee has been doing.
Okay.
And, you know, talking about not new technologies, but innovations and things like that, that would have to be about these biodegradable coffee capsules, which are compatible with the Nespresso machines. Yes.
Let's look at some of the challenges that a lot of coffee farmers are facing. You talked a lot about the climate change that the world has been facing. I understand that coffee has certain conditions for them to grow. What are some of the things that these coffee farmers are facing right now?
So, you know, I think one of the biggest problems is that only 20% of the coffee in Indonesia is shade grown.
Okay.
So, shade grown coffee means that it's not just a monoculture of coffee, but it is grown with other fruit-bearing plants.
You can talk,
like maybe bananas or citrus fruits. And because it's a monoculture, that means there has been a great deal of deforestation that's been happening. Right, and you know, with deforestation, obviously there are negative impacts towards the environment, but also with having these large swaths of monocultures, that is not a sustainable practice, because you know, in decades' time, that soil will be, you know, it'll be useless to plant coffee, to plant anything else. So in maintaining shade-grown coffee, where you have not just the coffee trees, but you have all these like other plants as well, like I mentioned before, banana and citrus
and whatnot. So you have to grow these coffees along with other fruits and whatnot.
And that ensures that erosion won't happen, therefore the farmers won't lose their land.
Right.
We're ensuring that it's a sustainable practice, which means that, you know,
again, we're looking into, we're taking into the future of these women farmers and whatnot. We're ensuring that they're not that their future is secure,
yes,
at least.
Yes.
And then we've also seen a trend, at least in the past few recent years, is that a lot of these people from the village and whatnot, they're not really interested in farming anymore.
Yeah.
They kind of want to move into the big cities, pursue jobs within the cities. Is there anything that Java Mountain Coffee is doing to kind of raise that awareness and say, hey, you guys, this is still something that we can be doing?
I think that is in part because, the youngsters that grew up in those conditions feel and believe that it's not a lucrative business and it's not something that can provide them financially in the future. And with setting up these cooperatives, with setting up the Women's Empowerment Innovation Fund, with ensuring that these premiums from these certifications go straight back to them, I think that in itself is beginning to clear the mist and beginning to clear the haze of any misconceptions that actually it will be possible to live a financially stable life from doing this.
From doing this, right. Yeah. Then, unfortunately, we have a limited time. I do have, however, one final question for you. Where do you see social enterprises, cooperatives, in the next 10 years?
In Indonesia?
Yeah.
As I mentioned before, I think the awareness is growing. Mm-hmm. And with that awareness, there's a lot of compassion, there's a lot of care towards the people that are most affected. And it is a slow process, but I feel like at the moment, there is nothing like Java Mountain Coffee that is doing these same things. But I believe in other industries and other environments, these type of social enterprises have started to grow, and I can only see that, growing even more in the next couple of decades.
Right. Well, Nadine, thank you so much for coming into Perspective and sharing with us your thoughts and your beliefs on the coffee industry, on the agricultural industry in Indonesia. Thank you so much. Thank you for watching The Perspective.